Hey guys, welcome back. We are the Ninja Monkeys from ekvip.
Today we want to talk about arrays. An array is a data structure that stores a collection of elements with the same data type. It's always one contiguous memory area. The elements are accessible via an index. TwinCAT supports one-dimensional and multidimensional arrays of fixed and variable lengths.
So Yeknom, what is an array and when should I use it?
Look at this. In my example, I've got some containers with bananas. I know how much bananas are in each of these containers. In TwinCAT, this could look like this. For variables, B container 1 to 4. All variables are from the type int and the value assigned to them is the number of bananas which are in the container. Instead of declaring all these variables, you could declare one array with four elements, because the variables are all from the data type int. As data type, you can use elementary data types, user-defined data types and function block types. An advantage of an array is that I can easily change the index. Means if I got four more containers, I can easily change the upper index limit. Also, accessing the elements in the array is much faster than accessing variable after variable. I delete my four variables and write instead B container, array, open square bracket, 0, dot, dot, 3, closed square bracket, of, int. Here you can see the syntax. Variable name, array, dimension, of data type, equals initialization. Like every variable, we can also initialize an array. Colon, equal, open square bracket, in here you write the values of the array elements separated by commas, at the end a closed square bracket and a semicolon. If you have an array with a lot of elements in a row, which should be initialized with the same value, you can also write the values like this. Amount of elements and the assigned value in brackets. The dimension starts with the lower index bound. You don't have to start the index with a 1. You can start it with a 0 or even a negative integers, for example minus 12. The value of the upper bound must be larger than the value of the lower bound. The index bound need to be constant. You can't declare the variable up int equals 4 between var and end var and use it as upper bound. But you can use a constant variable. A constant variable can be used locally or globally. For declaring a constant variable, you write var and use the keyword constant behind the var. Between var constant and endvar, you can now declare the variables which you want to use for the upper index limit, and, or the lower index limit. Constant variables are used, because you may don't want a possible change of the variable during runtime. You can call a certain element of the array by writing the variable and the index number in square brackets. You can also use a variable to access an element of the array.
At this point, I want to mention the checkBound function. This is a function which deals with the bound violation of an array index. Click on POU, add, and select POU for implicit checks. The first of these function is the boundChecks function. That's the one we need. Check it and click on open. Don't edit the declaration part. In this part, you will find the following input variables. Index, this is the index of the array element. Lower, this is the lower bound of the array range. And upper, this is the upper bound of the array range. These are the input parameters for the function. The return value is the index of the array element, provided it is in the valid range. Otherwise, TwinCAT returns the upper or lower bound, depending on which bound was exceeded. We will demonstrate it. We have our variable bob a with the assigned value of 10. We write b container open square bracket bob a closed square bracket colon equal 15. It does not work. Nothing is happening. If we call the bound check function, the function checks if the assigned value is in the index range. In our case, it is higher than the upper bound. The last element of the array gets the value, which we assigned. You can change the function in the implementation part, depending on what you have in mind. Also, it is allowed to add local variables in the declaration part, just don't change the input variables. But mention, the checkbound functions are good in needs, but can lead to undesired behavior, e.g. you write calculated values to an array in a loop and your index exceeds the upper bound, you will overwrite the last element multiple times with values that don't belong to this index, and original value that belongs to this index is lost.
Thank you, Ajnan, for explaining this to us. I've got some good news, I received more containers with bananas. Let's have a look at them.
That's awesome, but Yeknam, now you got two rows. Four containers stored on four containers.
That's right.
I will change the upper index limit to 8 in TwinCAT.
No, Ajnan. We need to build a two-dimensional array. Because we have two rows now. In TwinCAT you can build multi-dimensional arrays, but it's recommended not to escalate that much with the dimensions. Let's look at our array in TwinCAT. To make our array two-dimensional, we have two options for declaring it. The first one is to write it like this, array 0, 1, 0, 3, of int. The first index is the row index, and the second the index of the columns in our example or for the first and second dimension if we talk about arrays in general. The second options is in my opinion more clearly to read. It is the array of arrays option. It is an alternative notation for multidimensional arrays. If you choose to declare your multidimensional array like this, a collection of elements is nested. You write b container, array, 0, 1, for rows and then of array, 0, 3, for the columns. Now we want to initialize them. Let's start with our first option. Colon equal open square bracket, here you write the values for each elements separated with brackets. You start with 0, 0, then the value for 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, after this the values for 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, as you may see, this can get a little confusing. With the second option it is easier to write and read. You write it like this, open square bracket, and then another one. In here you write the values for the first row, and close it with a square bracket, set a comma and do the same with the values for our second row, close the initialization part with a closed square bracket. Now let's start the program. As you can see there is a difference in how the different types of writing are displayed.
Hey Yeknam, look! A third banana delivery arrived at the harbor. Oh, and look, I think we need to build a three-dimensional array.
Yeah, let's quickly do this. Imagine the third dimension like a page in a book, the number of columns and rows are the same on every page. In our case we have two pages now, with two rows and four columns. TwinCAT displays 1000 array elements by default. If we have an array with an index that is larger and want to change the monitoring range, we have to do this in online mode. Double-click on the array. A dialog then opens in which you can set the start and end index of the desired monitoring range. 20,000 are the maximum of elements. In our examples we used arrays with fixed lengths, now we want to talk about arrays with variable lengths. Arrays with variable lengths can be used in function blocks, function and methods. You declare the array in the declaration section varinout. You can pass statically declared arrays to this type of arrays. Dynamic arrays created using the new operator must not be passed. If you use arrays with a variable length, the operator's lower bound and upper bound can be used to determine the index limits of the array that is actually used at runtime. As you can guess, lower bound returns the lower limit, upper bound returns the upper limit. My plan is to create a function that calculates the sum of all of my bananas in total. To do this, right-click on POU, add and click on POU. Here we check the function option and chose int as return type. We call our function bananaSum. First we change the var input to var inOut. We only can declare our array with variable lengths in this section. Now we declare our array. We do this, like with our other arrays, but instead of declaring an index with integer numbers, we put a star for every dimension separated by commas in the brackets. For my function, I need 4 variables, 3 to get the integer values from every dimension and 1 for the sum. They have the data type int. In the implementation part, we initialized the bSum variable with 0. After this, I will start a for loop. With a for loop, you can program repeated progresses. The syntax of a for loop look like this. Begin with the for. Then you add a loop counter variable. And write a colon and an equal sign behind it. Next an init value. Then write a to. And an end value. Optional, you can add and by and after it, a certain step size. Now write do. After the do, the instruction follows. The for loop ends with end for and a semicolon. For my purpose, I will do the following. I write. For b1 colon equal, now I use the lower bound operator, in brackets I write the name of my array, b number and separated by a comma the dimension. This is my init value. Next we write, 2. As end value we take the upper bound operator. And after it do. Before we write our instruction we do the same for the other two dimensions. We change the init variable and the dimension of the array. Now we write our instruction. We use our bSum variable. After the colon and equal, we write bSum plus, bNumber, 1, 2, 3. This function adds the integer values of our array elements and return the calculated sum. After our for loops we now write. BananaSum equals bSum. This is important to get the sum. Now we pass our array bContainer to this function. To do so, we go back to main. We declare a variable. We call it BabaSum. In the implementation part we write. BabaSum equals bSum, number equals bContainer. Let's activate the configuration and look how much bananas I've got in total. Log in and start the program.
Oh wow. Yeknam. That's a lot.
Yeah, Ajnin. I would suggest to end with the arrays for now, instead we should bake some banana bread before the bananas go bad.
Let's do so. We wish you a great day, lots of bananas, and don't forget to subscribe, for not missing new content.
Bye.
Bye-bye.